So a group of multiple types of antibodies to thyroid trypsosomes that thyroglobulin, the patient develops autoantibodies to TSH receptors. The TSI of thyrosinating immunoglobulin, it binds to the TSH receptor, مكان اللي على الكوليكولر سيلز لازم يمسك فيه TSH عشان يعمل activation of production of T3 and T4 or stimulation. BG an auto or immunoglobulin, an autoantibody or an antibody binds to this TSH receptor وبعمل عمل TSH فبعمل stimulation of the cells. Thyroid growth stimulating immunoglobulins or TGI كمان بعمل proliferation of these follicular cells عشان هيك ال hallmark of Graves' disease is hyperthyroid ولا hypothyroid أكينا hyper يكون very active very high elevated levels of T3 T4. Okay, some of the thyroid or antibodies TSH binding inhibitor immunoglobulins are there, but the net result, the TSI is more powerful in stimulation of the TSH receptors and production of T3 T4. So at the same time, the inhibitory immunoglobulins, so the stimulatory immunoglobulins. So the net result is the stimulation overruns the inhibitory effects. So smooth enlargement of the gland with diffuse hyperplasia and hypertrophy. Again, I think one of the immunoglobulins or TGI is a growth hormone or acts like a growth factor. Stimulates the proliferation of the thyroid tissue. So the size of the gland will be enlarged. نفس السيلز under the microscope هلا رح نشوفهم are hyperplastic, hypertrophic, and they acquire a columnar morphology. حكينا لما شفنا normally حكينا بتكون flat, cuboidal, very flattened. لما يصير لهم stimulation by these immunoglobulins antibodies, يصيروا they increase in number and they increase in size as well. They undergo hyperplasia and hypertrophy. Colloid, minimal thin colloid with scallop edges usually become free, very active cells. عشان هيك they consume more and more colloid for production of T3 T4. وبصير شكل colloid is thin and scallop edges. Scallop يعني زي كأنه في فراغات على الأطراف. الأطراف اللي next to the follicular cells لأنهم they are over functioning, they are over producing T3 and T4. بصير شكل colloid is thin. يعني شوي افتح من الطبيعي وسكالوب ايجز اللي هم الفراغات من الاطراف in the colloid. شايفين الفوليكولار سيلز these are columnar architecture. شايفين كيف الفوليكل صاروا columnar سيلز صاروا اكبر عددهم اكبر وحتى حجمهم صاروا columnar instead of flattened. So they are very highly functioning عشان هيك بيعملوا hyperthyroidism and thyrotoxicosis. The extrathyroidal tissue اللي حكينا أهم واحد من المانفستيشنز is exophthalmus بتذكروا وحكينا على البريتيبيال ميكسيديما كمان and these are the main two symptoms اللي بتصير بالجريفز ديزيز. الإكسوفثالمس ليش بتصير؟ بصير فيها inflammation of the ocular muscles and infiltration of the retroorbital tissue اللي ورا الآي أوربت. The inflammation and accumulation of inflammatory cell infiltration and accumulation of edematous fluid. فشو بيصير بالايبول؟ بتطلع لبرا اكسو ثالمس. اي شيء هي اكسو معناته ايش؟
The outside.
يعني صار في protrusion outside. لما يكون the orbits are protruding outside, the buccal islets are able to lubricate them. The buccal islets with the receptor RNA. So these patients, they present with severe dryness of the eye, sometimes ulceration, and they might lose their sight if left untreated. Thickening of the skin and subcutaneous tissue, and accumulation of glucose aminoglycans, which are hydrophilic, in the tissues. حكينا أكثر شيء بيجي pre-tibial areas. pre-tibial areas بيجي شو نسميها pre-tibial myxedema. حكينا نشوفها both in hypothyroid and in Graves disease. Hypothyroid. See the accumulation of substances. pre-tibially or in different sides of the body, مش بس pre-tibially, بس the most common location is anterior to the tibia. And the appearance is variable in pre-tibial myxedema. It could be only edema, between the edema, and it could be swelling in the area of the pre-tibial skin. Sometimes it could be patches, development of lesions, skin lesions, due to this disease. زي ما حكينا the displacement of the eye wall and exophthalmos leads to dryness and ulceration and infection in the conjunctiva. Because زي ما حكينا the expression of aberrant TSH responding to circulating anti-TSH receptor antibodies and inflammatory lymphocytic reaction. وهذا inflammation it might involve retro orbital areas. وين شكل الإكسوفثالموس؟ بصير في protrusion of the eye مع association of dryness, sometimes ulceration, and other diseases related to the eye. And then the question, please. Yes, it could happen with other autoimmune diseases. هلا هذا الإشي اللي سألتونا عنه diffuse non-toxic and multinodular goiter. Goiter is a very general term, معناته enlargement of the thyroid. أي شيء يزيد the size of the thyroid يسمى goiter. Most common cause is iodine deficiency. زي ما حكينا, because there is impaired synthesis of T3, T4, below the TSH عالي, and it tries to stimulate the cells to produce T3, T4, بس ما في أصلاً raw material, iodine is not there. هلا صار بيفوع الملح, الايودان صار وين لا بيفوع الملح الطعام. So this inability of the thyroid to produce T3 and T4 due to the lack of iodine deficiency, يعني شيء مش موجود, ما في ايودان, this leads to elevation of TSH. TSH بيعمل لي hypertrophy, hyperplasia of the follicles, بس ما في production of T3, T4. This produces an abnormal response to the follicular cells, and they become nodular, multinodular, زي ما حكينا. Goiter, بصير في nodules, formation of the neck, particularly the eye, and enlargement of the thyroid. ليش نسميها diffuse بعدين multinodular؟ احنا حكينا diffuse is something affecting the whole gland. حكينا it could be smooth زي أي disease بيعمل smooth enlargement.
Graves.
زي لب Graves زي كمان ما بعمل nodules Graves زي مثلا ال Hashimoto's بيعمل diffuse smooth. شو يعني diffuse smooth؟ Diffuse يعني كل ال thyroid glands enlarged. Smooth يعني ما في nodules. In this case. It starts as diffuse بالأول, بتكون بالبداية smooth, بس later on it develops nodules. زي ما حكينا, the TSH stimulation continues on and on. بصير في formation of masses in the thyroid, enlargement of the thyroid, which is goiter, and multinodular, معناته في formation of masses. In endemic areas, if you have iodine deficiency, more than 10% of the population have goiter. And sometimes sporadic physiological demands, say for example in case of pregnancy, because the iodine is not enough. A dietary intake of excess of calcium and cabbages, they interfere with the absorption and the function of the iodine in calcium-containing food and the cabbages. And sometimes hereditary inflammatory defects, because the hereditary abnormality, while which makes the thyroid unable to use the iodine. زي ما حكينا, initially diffuse, بالبداية بيكون smooth enlargement. Later on with nodular, with degenerative changes, colloid cysts, hemorrhages, and fibrosis. بصير كل زي ما حكينا structure of the thyroid, abnormal. أماكن يصير فيها necrosis, أماكن فيها regeneration and hemorrhage. If large may extend retrosternally, ممكن تكون ورا السبرنا. لما يصير فيها extension retrosternally بتعمل لي symptoms related to breathing difficulties. Sometimes بيكون في other signs بتعرفهم لما تروح على إن شاء الله الجراحة, كيف بعرف إنه patient عنده retrosternal goiter أو لا. Pressure symptoms are a common complaint. Pressure على the upper airways, pressure على the structures اللي around the neck. Picture is that of varying size follicles, hemorrhage, fibrosis, cysts, and calcification. Patient is often euthyroid but may be toxic or hypofunctioning. So, variable presentations. But most commonly they present with hypothyroid. بشكل very severe. Multinodular growth, which I think you conditioned thyroid and enlarged, so فيها masses, say rounded structures. This is another picture. شايفين هدول structures which are round. هدول بسميهم nodules. وبحسهم تحت ايدي الثايرويد. This is another picture. شايفين كيف على cut section فيها nodules, فيها colloid cysts, زي هون. Areas تكون عبارة بس colloid. The whole architecture of the multinodular goiter is disturbed. Adam, do you want to know? The nodules and the thyroid. How is she? The thyroid keeps the hospital. If I look at the thyroid is enlarged or not, when I come to the hospital, and if I look at this is something related to the thyroid or not. How is she? الثايرويد لا هلا بالفحص السريع المقصود. الثايرويد is located anterior to the neck and it's enclosed with the trachea, صح؟ يعني it's adherent to the trachea. So any movement in the trachea or any movement of the trachea or the larynx in general كمان رح تعمل لها movement. عشان هيك احنا كيف نعرف إنه patient عنده a nodule or a mass that's related to the thyroid؟ تحكي له ابلع طب بعطيه مي او ابلع ريقه اذا تحركت لفوق تحت مع البلع this means انه this is something related to the thyroid. So nodules in the thyroid, nodule بشكل عام معناتها something forming a mass زي ما حكيت لكم عامل زي كتلة او شيء هيك nodules in the thyroid may be multiple or solitary either become a single nodule or multiple nodules. Any solitary nodule in the thyroid has to be investigated as some angioplasty. كيف بعمل لها investigation زي ما حكى زميلكم؟ بالعادة ما بنعمل we do not proceed into biopsy لأنه biopsy بدها opening of the leg. نعمل شيء نسميه ال FNA, fine needle aspiration. Fine needle aspiration اني بحاول اخذ منها خلايا بميد العادي بالسرنج العادي بسحب منها خلايا وبحطها على السلايد وبشوفها as cells. Radioactive imaging techniques, so like for my example, ultrasound and the levels of TP40SH. Hot nodules, هذا هو radioactive iodine uptake. بعمل labeling the iodine by something that is radioactive. وبعمل له بعدين بصوره اللي هو بسميه technetium. أصوره بصورة to detect this iodine. Normally هذا الأيودين بدخل على الثايرويد بلاند which produces إشي بسميه hot nodule. Hot nodule is the one on the left side. شايفين كيف ماخذ الradioactive iodine بالأسود. الأماكن اللي بتاخذ radioactive iodine بتبين لونها أسود والأماكن اللي ما بتاخذ بتبين أبيض. So hot nodule معناته إيش؟ مش 100% اوكي مش 100% طب نوديول معناته this nodule is functioning قاعد تشتغل بتطلع T3 وبتطلع T4 لانها دليل انها اخذت radioactive iodine اوكي so on the left side بسميها hot nodule شايفين كيف دائره او ماس ما اخذت اللون الاسود اللي هو radioactive iodine in the middle picture شايفين في area بالثايرويد بلاند مش ماخذة بالمرة radioactive iodine معناتها هاي
non-functioning
بسميها cold nodule. Picture number one, this is normal appearance of the pyroplasm. كلها diffusely تاخذ radioactive iodine with the same intensity. معناته اللي بالنص cold nodule on the left side hot nodule. ما في شيء يعني على المطلق يتعمم على هذول النوديولز. بس in general ما في تعميم مطلق, okay؟ بس in general hot nodules takes up radioactive iodine as substances and is functional. We'll call the nodules does not take it up and they are non-functional. نيجي على general rules. General rules. Solitary nodule is more likely to be neoplastic than multiple. يعني لو يكون multiple بفسرها انها could be multinodular golden أكثر. بس لما تكون solitary nodule this is more likely to be neoplastic. Neoplastic يعني تشمل الدينوين تشمل المالينة الأدينوما أو الكارسينوما. Hot nodules are more likely to be benign. زي ما حكيت إذا كانت hot بطمن أكثر يعني بس مش على المطلق يعني هلا الفاينل diagnosis is on the excision. بشيل الجزء اللي النوديول وبشوف تحت الميكروسكوب بشوفه جرافلي. بس in general the hot nodules are more likely to be benign. At the same time, not every cold nodule is malignant. Sometimes it can be non-functioning adenomas or colloid cysts. The man colloid might be asked for killer cells, but it could be some happy colloid. Nodule of nodular goiter. Up to 10% only of cold nodules prove to be malignant. Yeah, if it cannot cold, it has a higher chance of being malignant. Less than 100%. Only 10% of cold nodules they prove to be malignant. مفهوم؟ أحيانا في بعض المالجنسية ممكن تبين as hot nodule يعني ما في تعميم مطلق بس إذا تتحول من hot into cold إذا كانت مثلا part of hot nodular golden وصار فيها مثلا collection of colloid أبد colloid ممكن yes بس in general زي ما حكينا if it is cold and solitary it's more likely to be malignant. لما تكون cold and a single lesion بتصير شوي alarming يعني بصير لازم أعملها more and more investigation. younger patients are more likely to be neoplastic. الصغار are more likely to be neoplastic. وفي certain types of malignancies ممكن تصير even بالchildren اللي هو papillary carcinoma of the thyroid حتى بالchildren ممكن تصير. Nodules in males are more likely to be neoplastic. Usually, autoimmune diseases and other etiologies are more common in females. The malignancies are more common in males. History of previous radiation to the neck is associated with increased risk of malignancy. Neoplasms of the thyroid, they are the most common endocrine tumors, responsible for about 6 misses per million person annually. Accounts only for 0.5% of all cancers in men and 1.5% of all cancers in women. The thing that is important to remember with thyroid cancers is that they are treatable, accessible. I mean, thyroid is an organ that is subcutaneous, يعني تحت السكن مباشرة, and outside the organs, ما فيها كثير risk of bleeding like other tissues. So, detection of tumors in the thyroid can protect the patient from metastasis outside. We can see if you have tumors, they metastasize into lymph nodes, or if you have the tumors, it metastasizes to the bone and to the brain. So it's important to detect these lesions early and before they start to metastasize and go outside the thyroid. 5% of all thyroid nodules are malignant. Single nodule more likely to be malignant than multiple nodules. Same again, single is more likely to be malignant. Cold is more likely to be malignant in male and young ages and in male. Neoplasms of the thyroid, it could be benign and adenoma. Usually single, well-defined capsule, common in follicular with herpes cell change, and maybe toxic, sometimes to cause over-functioning, to tell the thyrotoxicosis. and size is variable between 1 to 10 centimeters, variable color. مهم كثير هلا بعد شوي لما نحكي على الطائر follicular carcinoma. The distinction between هلا رح نحكي an adenoma and a follicular carcinoma. Follicular carcinoma من اسمها معناها بتعمل follicles. So تشبع الطائر والتشو العام. The most important is اللي هون لاتيكو بليز الجهة اليمين. يميني أنا بحكور لو سمحتوا خلاص بليز ما حدا يحكي ولا أنتوا ولا حدا يحكي بليز لو سمحتوا في ناس حواليكم بتستفيد بليز لو سمحتوا كنا نحكي عن follicular carcinoma and follicular adenoma. الأدينوما زي ما حكينا it could be surrounded by a capsule, well demarcated capsule, complete capsule. حوالين كل الأدينوما بتكون surrounded by a capsule وما في invasion, ما في cells طالعين عن الكابسول. لما يصير في invasion بسميها follicular carcinoma. رح نحكي عنها in details عن follicular carcinoma. Pathogenesis of adenoma. TSH receptor signaling pathway plays an important role in the pathogenesis of toxic adenomas. Activating mutations of the TSH receptor, the zero overactive and the normal, activates the cyclic or increases the production of cyclic AMP and this stimulates the proliferation of follicular cells. So, primarily, benign tumor composed of follicular cells that are proliferating, the same adenoma. 20% have blast oncogenes, PIK3CA, PAPS, PDAR, GGN fusions. Microscopically, زي ما حكينا بتشبه الثايرويد تشو العادي بس شوي بيكون الـ follicles are more crowded. الـ follicles أصغر فيهم أكثر cells. And it's surrounded by a complete capsule. شايفينها محطوطة هون underline. Integrity of the capsule is important in the differentiation of adenoma from undifferentiated follicular carcinomas. عشان هيك أي case of nodule in the thyroid لازم تنشاف كل النودول. ليش؟ عشان أشوف الكابسول على كل الأطراف. أتأكد إنه في كابسول بكل الأطراف وما في invasion into this capsule. Capsule or vascular invasion, this means a follicular carcinoma. بتبطل adenoma. بطل benign بتصير
carcinoma.
This is an example of a thyroid adenoma. شايفين الوايت تشو هذا اللي around this is the capsule. Under the microscope مكونة من follicles more crowded at a distance of 10 من 48 and it is surrounded by capsules which are highlighted by the others. تكون الكابسول surrounding the whole adenoma. To compare, بعد شوي رح نرجع نشرحها. This is a capsule invasion. Cells دخلوا على الكابسول. عملوا زي مشروم structure. احنا نسميها مشرومة. زي شكل حبة المشروم. This is a malignant tumor. This cannot be an adenoma. This is a follicular carcinoma. تحكوش انتو شباب مش فاهم. بس بليز خلاص. Thyroid or carcinoma of thyroid, the incidence is about 1-2% of malignancies. They have 0.5 in males and 1.5 in females. So the range is 1-2%. Wide age range depending on the type. And generally commoner in females, but in tumors occurring in children or elderly, equal incidence in both sexes. Most are derived from follicular cells, and few are derived from the C cells or the polyfollicular cells. Let me hear now one by one. The types of follicular carcinoma, the most common is papillary cancer. Between 75-85%, usually the usual type in children. يعني the children, if they can't be tumored with thyroid, it's most likely to be a papillary thyroid cancer. Follicular carcinoma, 10-20% and more in middle age. Medullary carcinoma, 5% over 50-60. We'll talk in details كل واحد. والأناپلاستيك كارسينوما is fortunately less than 5% in old ages. The presenting symptom, the most important presentation, is a mass. زي ما حكينا. Maybe incidental in a multinodular goiter, especially capillary and follicular. يعني بيكون نشيل الثايرويد for multinodular goiter. ولما نعملها سكشنين بيبين عندي ماس، لما نشوفها تحت الميكروسكوب تطلع capillary or follicular cancer. Pathogenesis. Genetic lesions, most tumors are sporadic familial cases. Usually we see فيها capillary type in the thymus T cells, and the next familial type is papillary carcinoma. Those are more likely to be inherited. Genes in papillary cancer, هلا رح فرجيكم كل واحد وين بيشتغل. The most important is the red PTC combination, which activates the red and MAP signaling pathways and leads to the net result of this whole process is proliferation of the cell, primarily stimulation of proliferation of the cell. Sometimes we see point mutations in BRAF oncogenes, which activates also the MAP signaling pathway. In follicular carcinoma, RAS is more common than the red PTC. The red PTC also أخذت اسمها من papillary thyroid cancer. يعني بس بروتين اللي بينتج من هذا ال combination gene أو fusion gene سموه red slash PTC هي papillary thyroid cancer PTC. So it's common in thyroid cancers. بالfollicular cancers زي ما حكينا الراس is more common. PTEN mutation also happens with PAX, BRAF gamma also can be seen. بالgene بالmedullary carcinoma is a red gene mutation as well. الأنابلاستيك the hallmark is the PIK3CA أو P53 mutation. The P53 mutation بيصير the most common اللي رح تسمعوا عنه أي tumor في P53 mutation بيكون سيء، بيكون very rapidly proliferating اللي هو هي أنابلاستيك كارسينوما. ليش سميناها أنابلاستيك كارسينوما؟ لأنها أول شيء rapid growing وما بتعمل follicles، يعني بتكون poorly differentiated، ما بتشبه tissue cohesion. This is an illustration of the red PTC mutation that leads to activation زي ما حكينا of a cascade of genes and the net result is proliferation of the cell. Sometimes it's even the BRAF mutation زي ما حكينا point mutation بالpapillary cancer. RAS mutation is more common in follicular cancer. PTEN also in follicular cancer. So, كل net result of all of these mutations and the chromosomal rearrangements that we see is the proliferation of the follicular cells. Environmental factors. If you remember, حكينا إنه ionizing radiation, radiation exposure to the neck and the head predisposes more to having thyroid cancers. Most common is papillary cancer with red gene rearrangement. Incidence of follicular cancer is more in endemic areas of iodine deficiency. And there can be continuous accumulation of these cells that they might arise into or may develop into follicular cancer. Pre-existing thyroid lesions, they may have been a multinodular goiter for a very long time. And Hashimoto's thyroiditis predisposes lymphomas. فاهمين؟ هلا رح نحكي على كل تيومر 1 باي 1 5 باي 5. Papillary carcinomas زي ما حكينا called on scan by radioactive iodine could be solitary or multiple, multifocal, solid or cystic with calcification and composed من اسمها papillary architecture. رح أفرجيكم شايفين كيف شكل التيومر زي كأنه في finger like projections زي papillary projections هذا بسميها papillary thyroid CA. The most important feature in diagnosis of papillary thyroid carcinoma is بالأحمر شو مكتوب؟ nuclear features. شو يعني nuclear features؟ يعني بتطلع على the nuclei of the cells. If they have إشي بسمي intranuclear inclusion, clear nuclei شكلهم pale فاتح لونه with grooves جروس بيكون فيهم زي كوفي بين ستركتشر زي اللي قلت لنا هلا بفرجيكم اياها اللي قلت لنا اللاين جوينج ثرو ذا نيوكليوس انترا نيوكليير انكلوجنز بيكون في ان اريا انسايد ذا نيوكليوس لونها زي لون السايتوبلازم بسميها انترا نيوكليير انكلوجن اند سموها بعدين Metastasis main violent nodes before the papillary cancer. Hematogenous spread is very late and prognosis is generally good. Papillary cancers, they carry a good prognosis generally. شايفين شكلهم. This is the group. اللي عليه الارو, the lower part. شايفين كيف كأنه في خط ماشي through the nucleus. هذا بسميه intranuclear group. الأبر left side arrow بفرجيني intranuclear inclusion nucleus وبنصها في مكان لونه نفس لون السيتوبلازم مش زي لون النيوكليوس وحكينا nuclear clearing and other features nuclear features are the most important for diagnosis of papillary cancer حتى لو شكلهم تحت الميكروسكوب مش papillary إذا شفت فيهم nuclear features this is a papillary thyroid CA هاي شكل كيف clearing of the nuclei لونها فاتح clear and سموها بديت عبارة عن ايش calcification ممتاز laminated calcification في زي طبقات طيب احنا almost there يعني نعمل شيء the follicular cancer حكينا the most important diagnostic feature of follicular cancer هم ايش
Absolutely.
Invasion, capsule invasion or vascular invasion, and all vascular invasion. One of them is enough. So usually cold but rarely functional. Well, second strike with thick capsule. زي ما حكينا, sometimes we show here invasion. Or most of the time we show here invasion composed of follicles, sometimes of Kupffer cells. And once we see capsule projected here, they're mushrooming. Invasion or malignant cells through a blood vessel, vascular invasion. This is malignant. Metastasis is usually it's different from papillary. Papillary حكينا بتروح على lymph nodes. In follicular, they metastasize or it metastasizes by blood into the lung, bone, and liver, and etc. Treatment is by surgery and radioactive iodine and thyroxine. لكن الراديواكتيف ايودين sometimes نستعملها as treatment لأنها ممكن تعمل killing of these neoplastic cells. The prognosis is not as good as the papillary except in minimally invasive very well differentiated forms. يعني in general follicular carcinomas do worse than أسوأ من papillary cancers. هاي شكل follicular cancer شايفين. This is the nodule or this is the tumor مفتوح بالنص. وهذا كابسول انفيجن اللي حكينا عنه زي المشلومين. Third type is medullary carcinoma. Medullary carcinoma ما بتطلع من الفوليكيولار سيلز بتطلع من باريفوليكيولار من السي سيلز. عشان هيك a very important feature of medullary carcinoma is the production of amyloid. هلا رح تشوفوا. So arises from T cells producing calcitonin, somatostatin, serotonin or VIP. 80% survival. Or familial with or without Down syndrome. Neither will find close enough. So 80% sporadic. It could be familial part of Men's syndrome. Men, the multiple endocrine neoplasia. We can be tumors. We'll take them later on. Tumors in multiple endocrine organs. Composed of polygonal or spindle cells. Usually with the demonstrated or demonstrable amyloid in the stromal pathogenia. Calcitonin can be seen in the cells and in the blood. So you see هذا الأرو على area فيها material which is xenophilic acellular cells amyloid deposition. وإيش الستين بستعملها للأميلويد؟ إيش الستين اللي بس فيها الأميلويد؟ الكونجوريت ستين. Conquered, we make the amyloid orange or orange to reddish in color. وإذا ما حطيته على polarizing microscopy, we make green by infringing. Level of calcitonin in serum may be useful for follow-up. And family members may show cecil hyperplasia. عشان هيك it's very common in men syndrome زي ما حكينا. إذا كان واحد من العائلة عنده cecil أو medullary carcinoma, it's better to screen the others for this tumor, the family members for this tumor. Metastasis by bloodstream and prognosis intermediate worse in men type 3. نشوف المن في multiple endocrine neoplasia. You have multiple types. None of them have to be which is the worst type of medullary cancer. آخر شيء رح نحكي عنه الأنابلاستي. Usually بتصير بالelderly persons. حكينا الأنابلاستي is something very bad. You can see the mutation rapidly proliferating. But after slide, please خليكم معي. يلا please خليكم معي. Okay. 5 minutes. نخلص. يلا بليز لو سمحت. طيب آخر شيء رح نحكي عنه الأنابلاستيك كارسينوما. الأنابلاستيك كارسينوما من اسمها something bad, something very rapidly proliferating, something invades the بيدخل على النيك تيشوز, على الباريثايروز, على السوفت تيشو, على السكين around. So usually it happens in elderly patients with multinodular goiter in 50% of the cases. Sometimes we show جنبها the focus of follicular or papillary that acquired P53 mutation وصار anaplastic. Sometimes it arises from other types. You see P53 mutation وبتحول لanaplastic. Markedly infiltrative tumor invading the neck, pressure on vital structures. زي ما حكينا it might invade to the trachea, to the skin, to the surrounding structures. Rapid progression and death is within 1 year, so it's a very bad tumor. Life expectancy is less than 1 year. Sorry. Morphology. زي ما حكينا أي شيء أنا بلاستيك معناته ما بشتغل بشوف origin. ما في follicles, ما في formation of colloid. So pleomorphic giant cells, spindle cells, small cells, بس كلهم ما بشتغل follicular cells of origin. And it might be even confused with lymphoma sometimes. Radio sensitive tumor, and we do not operate. لأنه بالعادة at the type diagnosis become invading the whole structures around. ما نقدر أصلاً نشيله. Not radio therapy. P53 mutation identified consistent with tumor progression. So P53 is a very bad in all tumors. When I can't get tumor, P53 mutation. This means this is a high grade probability. Had any questions?